Americans had wished for more land so they could own more cotton farms. So they realized that Texas would be a good place to start those, so they had decided to travel there.
Howdy, I'm Stephen Austin.
Hola, I'm General Santa Ana.
Hey, I was wondering if I can use your land for some cotton farms.
As long as they are Mexican brothers and all follow the Catholic faith.
Also, I know some Americans that would also like to come here. Is that all right with you?
Either way, it will boost our economy.
Stephen Austin.
Yes, William Travis.
Santa Ana has said we have invited too many Americans here and that we outnumber them 25-4. They're going to close our borders. This means war!
William Travis, you hothead. I believe that we can prevent war by talking to General Santa Ana. I will take our demands of reopening Texas border and to make it a separate Mexican state in order for us Texans to run our own affairs.
In 1833, Austin arrives in Mexico and is not received with the warm welcome he expected. Instead, he was tossed in jail for promoting rebellion. He is released in 1835 and Texans revolted. As can be expected, Santa Ana marched north with about 6,000 troops.
Following a 12-day siege, Mexican troops under General Santa Ana launched an assault on the Alamo. On March 6, 1836, Santa Ana gave the order to attack, and the battle lasted 90 minutes, killing all the defenders, including Davy Crockett and James Bowie. Santa Ana's cruelty during the battle fumed rage that cried out for revenge.
Sam Houston understands the people's rage and devised a plan to draw the Mexican army into Texas, in hopes for it to make it difficult for General Santa Ana to supply his army and keep its battle ready. Houston's strategy was not popular, but it worked.
Oh, I just got a great idea! I will lead the Mexican troops to the San Jacinto River, and I will wait until they and their general go to... This is for the Alamo. Remember the Alamo!
The Texans overran the Mexican camp. Santa Ana escapes the attack but is captured the next day. In exchange for his freedom, he removes all his troops out of Texas. This marks the independence of Texas.
I'm Southern, and I believe we should have more cotton and more slaves with more land with Texas.
I'm a Northerner, and I disagree with that.
Well, the Texans want to join us.
Okay, then.
So then Texas had become a part of the Union, and now they have a slightly separate identity, but still are, in fact, American.
Out in the land where the wild, wild west was won. Out in the land of the desperado. If you're as soft as an avocado, yee-haw! Your front row is on. Oh, they say it, pal, ho, 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 on the range.